Hey guys, this is Coach Chris. Welcome to my channel where we break down international level fights for strategies and tactics that you can use in your matches. Today we're watching CIV, Cote d'Ivory, versus Uzbekistan, Rostov Ulugbek, the gold medal Olympian. This one's pretty good. The first round kind of blowout, but the next two rounds are pretty close. I've only watched it one time and skimmed it through, so let's get into it. Ooh, a little bit low. Good aggression here, both sides. Super strong front leg. Forward. So, if you're fighting Uzbekistan, you really have to watch that front right leg. He has a left leg back kick, and I believe the left leg in the clinch. Yeah, I believe this one goes through, so just as a word to the wise, guys, if you're injured, either go all the way down and take the gumjung, go all the way out and take the gumjung, but don't do, like, be fully committed to getting out and keeping yourself safe, because now you're getting a gumjung, losing the point, and he hit you in the head, so that's three. So make sure you really take the full knee or take the full out. I think they wave it off. Yeah, they leave it. That front right leg is crazy good. And strong. It's super strong. Yeah, so like I said, this first round's kind of a blowout. Nice return fire by CIV here. Nice adaptation. So I didn't notice this the first time. A lot of CIV has been front leg against Uzbekistan's front leg. And some, for those of you guys who are old school going to new school, complaining about new school, it's like, yeah, it's over. Of course it's going to be front leg. Well, there's different things you can do. But I like this little adjustment here by Uzbek. He kind of does this cover punch. Kind of a Daehoon-ish cover punch to go for that body shot. That was pretty interesting. Nice little technique. Nice try there. Like that's this guy's really innovative. Good stuff. Good try. I mean, CIV is really doing anything he can to try and make up points in this last minute. 11-3-11 down with 1 minute left is pretty hard to go, pretty hard to do. So I think maybe he's just at this stage, maybe trying to just gather information. Oh my god, there's that killer back kick. Should be a plus two. Plus two, I believe, ends the round. Yeah. So, any super good strategy stuff to break down there in there? Kind of not really. The reason I don't really break it down too much is because all the points, it seemed like, out of Uzbekistan were straight up just cuts or directional, like first step counters. There, I didn't see any too much change of play besides him trapping CIV's front leg in that cover punch. But besides that, it's nothing too out of the ordinary that I would say. It's like the axe kick he lands earlier. Obviously, it's aggressive cut. He knows his opponent's standing there, so he goes for the axe kick. He's not sure if he hits it the first time, so he tries to bring it back. A lot of the other points of the body, same kind of deal, just bring it on the aggression. So it's not like there's too much for me to break down and go look at this setup, because it's like if you kick someone and then it scores, there's, you don't really have to think too much, right? Nice. Trying for 2-1-2 instead of just singles. I think he's expecting Uzbekistan to fight in place. Yeah. Fair enough. Pretty good because CIV is bringing the aggression. Nice try. So if I were Uzbekistan in this situation, a lot of movement is straightforward. If I was Uzbek, I would motion forward and be sitting on op ball because this guy is obviously trying to bring the fight to you. So a good way to trap that would be to chunjin, so slide forward, get him to come in, and then slide back op ball. Oh, or vice versa. I forgot this happened in this round. So bait Uzbek to come get him. That was the interesting about this too is that it's not a straight up, in my opinion. I think this is a slightly off. They call these off timing hits, where I think you might do a fake to the body and go ahead. Oh no, I would say it's just an off timing where it's slightly delayed, and sometimes it screws with when everyone's firing fast, and you go fast. Then it's it kind of screws up the timing. So I think this was unintentional, but it was good off timing op ball by CIV there. Good off timing hit. So CIV's game seems like it's changed. Oh, this is really fast adjustments here that I'm noticing now. So CIV's game has changed. The initial part of the round brought pressure, tried to make it so that way Uzbekistan aggresses him back. When he does do that, he hits the counter. And this one, it's kind of getting red though, because he's these last ones he's trying for a to move back at least one time, and then counter going forward. So the last one, Uzbek came in, hit with the op ball. And this next one, he slid out and then came back in. The way you counter that, I was gonna say, but Uzbek already adjusted it to it, was a two. You have to attack kind of two steps deep. So boom, out and in. And now he goes deep twice because he knows the game plan is slide back one and go. So if it's slide back one and go, then if you cut and they slide back one on your second cut, if you're extending and they're trying to go, they're going to run into your cut. So that's essentially what he did here. So fast on the adjustment here. Good motions. Okay. This is the part where I was like, okay, so this was good mode. I think because, so this is interesting because thought process at this point was, I know he knows the game plan because he hit too deep. So he knows I'm trying to beat. This part right here was to kind of get him, throw him off the trail, which is good because he blew his position. After he reset, he blew his position, but he didn't have a game plan for what to do after that. And that's, so this is a kind of a slightly lost opportunity, which counts big at these level matches. But the good idea here would be better if he had this idea to kind of reset the match with a kind of offense in mind. Unless he really thought Uzbek was coming and he was sitting on a defense and they both kind of just feinted each other's stuff out. So after this third or fourth motion, Uzbek knows he's not really going. The map's a little bit reset, or the game's a little bit reset. Good D. Okay, so CIV now fighting in place. Changing the game plan a little bit because he knows Uzbek knows the other plan was to slide back and go. So all of this, oh nice. I was gonna say all of this may be an attempt to get Uzbekistan to reset the floor so that way he can bait Uzbekistan once more into, so standing in place, fighting in place, and fighting and going forward on each clash. Maybe a game plan to camouflage later after he goes, I can do the slide back one and counter. Like he used to score earlier. Game is still reset. I think that might be the game plan. Might be still trying to. Oh my gosh. Might be it's a reset that, but that's such a punishing kick. Punishing in terms of points. Like if you screw up on one of the hot balls, this guy has a sneaky back kick to float in. Nice. He's coming. Good fake to the good face. Oh. So body shot. Let's watch this in the entirety. Boom. Clash. Body shot. Scores. Kick to the flank. Kick to the flank, maybe. I want you guys also to notice something. So for some of you guys who are newer school fighters and just relying on this front leg, the game is starting to move a little bit more back toward footwork, more so than standing foot fencing, because you can't stand there and foot fence anymore because of the rules. So if you watch in this iteration, it's kind of easy to say, oh, he's making a miss, he's making a miss. But I want you to watch Uzbekistan's footwork to try and how he's baiting out each one of those kicks. He's destroying distance. He's going in and out, back and forth to not just fake with his upper body, but he's literally just moving and manipulating distance to try and thwart any kind of defense that CIV is sitting on so he can go in for that deep head kick. Watch his footwork here. Footwork. And then goes for the head. Really close. Really, really close. Almost hit. Oh, my God. So good. So this back kick was kind of previewed. But after that kind of aggression, deep aggression, and you falling on defense, the next general thing you're going to want to think of, at least that I would have thought of, was to go on offense just a little bit, just to hold him in place. Just a little bit of offense, even if I don't really want to go on offense, just to hold this dude in place. I think I skipped a whole round back. Okay. What happened here? This is the first round. What the heck? Okay. Watch this. Yeah, so this was a great trap because after this kind of aggression, the general thought process for most people is to reestablish pace, right? So if I were just on defense a lot and he's dictating pace, something I would do would be to cut hard or something, or cut fake to face or motion hard, because I want to reestablish dominance. But I would most likely, honestly speaking, have done that through a cut, because if you just fake and they come at you, then you're still getting the pace set to you. You're not dictating the pace in the match. You're not the one bringing the aggression. In general, you want to be the one bringing the aggression, right? So if I was just on defense and caught and my defense was blown multiple times and they tried for my head, something I would definitely do to try and get the pace of the match back would be to have been a cut. Uzbekistan, being a gold medal Olympian, knows this, is going for that back kick. All that thought process to say, that's why this is genius. He's trying to just, if you keep just float the backside, attack the backside, good job. Yeah, I would have taken that out of bounds all day. Good job by CIV to take a round off the Olympian here. Okay. So this is kind of a awkward spot. CIV knows that the game plan against him right now is at least to slide back one counter or to clinch him up, score in the clinch. He needs to score from, it looks like a lot of his points have been outside with a cut and the blitz head kick, or not blitz head kick, but like a shorter head kick mixed in with all of his pressure. So he could theoretically just stick to his same game plan. And I'm seeing for CIV, for Uzbekistan, I'd say either short distance kicks or super long. He doesn't want to be fighting in that middle too much. That'd just be my guesstimate, the way I'm looking at this. And for CIV, I would clinch a little bit more often in the beginning of the match, just to kind of set the tone that I'm going to be close, and so you should kick short. Once he starts kicking short, then do that one slide back and then go. Short to medium. They're at the spot where they're not sure what each other knows and how they're going to play the round, so they're kind of feeling each other out right now. One for one. Okay. That's not a bad idea. Fully unloading all the back kicks now because it's the last round and why not? I'm so scared him lifting that front leg now because of that back kick. And I think Uzbekistan is baiting it. I think that's why he keeps fighting with the front leg. You gotta throw that back. Throw backside. Back leg, backside. I meant for the other guy. Oh, he sneaked it out. What did you score here? Body shot in the clinch. That's just straight technique. Not really too much. Good technique, not too much strategy. That's just something you do when you're in the clinch. This bait for the back kick. This back kick bait is why CIV is so hesitant, because he doesn't want to fight that. What I am not sure of is, like, I think to fight this guy, if you had a strong backside kick, like kicks to the flank that can hang and hold position and hold space, I don't know what kind of techniques Uzbekistan has against that, except maybe punch. And if he does do punch, then you can just short flip to the face. So that'd be, maybe that's something that's not common. It's kind of like one of those lost art thingies. That's just an idea. I've never fought this guy. Actually, I've just watched him fight other people. But it seems like, given this dynamic, that's what the bait is now, is to trap into the back kick. I would just attack, hammer the flank a lot. What are you waiting for, dude? Yeah, I'm kind of questioning that also. There's so much fear of the back kick. That's why CIV is not coming in, because he doesn't want to come in with a cut. Come in with a back or double. You can double, so you can back. If you double with your front leg, do like a body, like a low cut kick, like something even to the knee, so it looks like a fake, and then kick to the backside, then you're kind of safe from the back kick. You can still engage. And then you end and you just keep hammering that backside and then flip that to the face eventually. I think because CIV's offense is so built off the cut, he doesn't know how to approach the situation anymore now that he knows Uzbekistan's trapping him with his initial offense. Good job though here. Backside, close. Not afraid to go one for one. Ooh! Good dodge. But good job to this guy crashing in like this. There's only 20, 30 seconds left, so I guess you have to go, but good freaking job, man. That takes a lot of courage. Courage under fire here. This very well may be a stall tactic. Maybe he got injured, actually. Maybe that's why he's not going anywhere. Maybe he was injured. Okay, we're losing time here. Oh! What a G. Just, oh man, look at, I skipped over this part, but like, I'm more impressed with his defense after missing than I am with the actual traps. Missed, and he knows 100% Uzbekistan's going to his face after he misses. Like, he didn't even see the kick. He just straight up, he knows it's coming. He just threw his hands up and said, Hail Mary. Miss and, oh my gosh, that is, I'm more impressed with the blind defense prediction than I am with the way Uzbekistan got around and almost cleaned his face with his foot. That was, my hat's off to this CIV guy for predicting that. Bro, if CIV won this fight, I can almost guarantee this replay would have been one of the highlights of the whole tournament, because that was such a good prediction. I'm still in awe about, like, you miss a back kick and then defend your face. Like, that is, this is also kind of, well, so CIV knows he's sitting on this, obviously, because this part here, he fakes it. He's still trying to get past it. Boom, favorite part. Yep, that little back motion was because Uzbekistan's trap got blown, right? So if I am CIV, I would just keep taking the races to the flank, because you won the first one. Just when you get in the clinch, watch your flank again, because it's coming. No, that was fair play. Why would you do that? Well, so wait, hold on. Did time stop? No, okay, it registered. Yeah. Ah, just a little bit more technique in the clinch, and that would have been a tie game. Or one down, I guess, because they gave him the gumjung. Technique matters, man. What are they doing? Is my... No, their thing has stopped because they're still talking about it. Makes sense. I mean, there's 9 seconds left. This is kind of the deciding point here. Denied. Okay, that's unfortunate. Yep. Attack the flank. Attack the flank. Attack the flank. What's he going to do now? Okay. Double underneath. Ah. Okay. If so, it's kind of ballsy, but if you guys are going to do this fake, I think you need, I see people do this and I think you need to eat more distance. This is not something I generally did just because I didn't bother to do that. I said, I'm just going to meet, my leg will meet your leg midair and I'm going to throw the double while I'm in the air. That's kind of how I got around this. I didn't generally do something like this. So here, watch this one more time. Technique, this is just more for technique. So when he blitzes to the side, notice he doesn't actually come in at all. I would rather you come in a little bit and then blitz. Watch his foot. So he kind of just goes to the side. So instead of coming in and being like when the guy throws a kick, being in distance for it to throw, all the guy had to do, because he didn't actually commit to the kick and he didn't actually come in, was he just moved his front foot to the side a little bit. That's not really the effect you want. I think maybe if you thought Uzbekistan was going to go for it, then yeah, sure, great position. But in general, when I see these kind of moves, I think more people need to commit a little bit more to eating the distance before moving to the side. I got scored on, so I'm pretty sure this is goes to Uzbekistan. I don't see anything crazy here. Also, I think I remember seeing something here. Yeah. So don't do this in a clinch. Like don't signal with your body what the back, like, you guys, most people who are not speaking English, if you're in your own country, please use your own dialect for this own reason. So you don't if Uzbekistan's looking at this guy when he does this, he knows. It's just there's a back kick coming. There's no other technique that this could be signaling. That's it. So if you have your own dialect with your coaches, if you guys have your own codes, please use those instead of signaling with your body in the match. Because even if he didn't see this, even if he doesn't see this, the coach looking at the ring just saw this and is going, he's gonna back kick you. He's gonna trap back kick you. Don't fight from your normal stance. Like, kick offsides or switch stance at the last second or jump. There's 2 seconds left. Because he's trying to back kick. So don't do this in a ring. I really don't think this is like, oh, I'm going to show a back kick, so he's going to think it's a back kick, so I'm going to counter what he's thinking. Like, I don't think it's that. I think he's tired and he just flashed a back kick. Don't do that. Okay. I mean, it is the only way to catch up, but there's a possibility of a headshot. There's possibility to do an Audubon, possibility for other stuff. That was actually pretty close. Low-key, those were pretty close. That was a good fight. Overall takeaways. One is, holy cow, good defense here by Blue, especially that third round. I like that block to the face. To fight Uzbekistan, it seems like you're going to need to hammer the flank and be faster on that race, and then be ready to fight him in close. I think overall good fight. Please take note that in order to thwart the defense on both sides, they both had to use footwork to thwart the defense. In this last little ending bit here, by the edge of the ring, not as good because he didn't come in. He didn't move into to Uzbekistan's fight close enough for him to actually get baited. So overall, great fight by CIV here, taking one round off the gold medal Olympian, fighting a close third round. And that's it for today, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed. Please like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys next time.